Jen, I feel like I'm talking too much on the video, so try to make this very quick. Not as much talk, okay? The main difference between Dao, Saber, and Sword is the way how the power is generated and the way how the cuts are made. So for Saber, the cuts usually go this direction because the power comes from your arm. The arm motion, the waist motion, it's like chopping the wood like an axe. That's why it was used by more simple people, okay? Like physical people, like people from villages, which using chopping the woods, that's why the saber motion is like this. So the cuts going this direction. And if we compare now this to the sword, with sword use mainly wrist, all the movements come from the wrist. So movement comes from the wrist, direction of the cut is this way. So that's why the sword is used by scholars, because they're using handbag for riding, so the wrist is more flexible. So the movements in the sword coming with the wrist and direction of the cut is this way. So sword mainly cuts this way, saber cut opposite, but doesn't mean that you actually do not have a boat. So saber as well has a cut going this way, and sword also has the movements the other way. But the bigger percentage of the movements in saber is this way, and sword is this way. Okay, so that's like basic general idea. Now, few basic movements. Okay, the first one is the horizontal cut. What we're doing the horizontal cut, like I mentioned, the movement comes from your arm. So it's not really a wrist, but it's a hand. It's an arm. It's an arm. So one. See, I'm doing the arm movement, then I'm letting go, bringing the safety to my waist, getting to my back, sliding over the neck. Some people go on the shoulder, some people go right over the neck. The most common one is the neck, so I'm using the common one, neck. Now, hand, I'm using this part, and I'm pushing. So cut, turn, cut, turn, okay? So this is a tie moment this way, okay? So if I can practice stationary, it's just like this. I want to use my body to rotate with the power of the saber, so I'm using the entire body to cut, not just here, yeah, okay? So it's cut, snap, cut, okay. Then if I want to use the stance, I'm using chin boom. What's in chin boom? And that's it. First direction. Now, second one is a block. This when I'm blocking, saber is pointed down 45 degrees, and as well, the blade of the saber is not flat, but it's also just like in the other one, it's the same idea. We hit 45 degrees this way. See, so you cannot just like destroy the blade. So, okay. When I'm blocking, I'm using my, just like my hand, I'm using my arm. So saber actually touching the arm. It's not blocked like this because I don't know how much you can withstand the hit, but way more you can withstand the hit this way. So the hand physically, the saber touching physically your arm during the block. And it's not pointed up, not pointed forward, but the blade is pointed 45 degrees. So again, 45 degrees, and now you can. Again, I'm using my arm, not my wrist. Using my arm, cut, and then I'm going back to my block. So, cut, going back to my block, up. Cut, going back to my block, up. And cut, up, cut. Of course, you can use it with your stances. One. Now we can combine these two movements. So, as we come to the very classical basic movement of saber, which first one is block, cut, then flipping the saber, holding close to your armpit, not the, some styles is lower, some styles is higher, the style I'm teaching is higher, and the tip of the saber is pointed up. Some stories say that the saber goes up like this so you can reflect the sun and get in the eyes of the enemy. If you're reflecting the eyes to the face enemy, you're basically also staring the sun. So I don't know how accurate is the story, but basically holding saber like this, I always see you are enough strong to hold the saber, otherwise you're like maybe not as strong in your wrist. So holding saber up again, so block, cut, and keep the saber up. Then bring the other hand to your elbow, And we'll continue cut back. Bring your hand to your armpit. Slide on your neck. Hand here and next to your knee. The tip of the saber next to the knee. Okay, and now again. Block. Cut. Okay. And now cut at the bridge. And next knee. Again, one. And cut. Two. And cut. And of course, one. Cut. Okay, the next place. Now we do a little bit of spins, which the spins are kind of coming from the sword motion from the wrist. So there's a spin inside. When I spin inside, I'm turning my blade. Again, this part I'm using for blocking, this part I'm using for cutting. So block, cut, block, cut. Same thing. So I go from inside, cut, inside, cut. Then I'm doing same thing from outside, turning my arm. Outside, block, cut, block, cut. So it's here and here. And then I can make it figure eight. What's very important, so you're holding the saber, the hand in the front, and moving from left to right. But don't bring it too close, you don't want yourself in the face. Okay, so basically, okay. Block, cut, block, cut, block, cut. Okay. And same thing, reversed. You can practice just one motion. When you practice one motion, block, cut. Okay, block, cut. Cut on this side. Okay, so, and then you can do a figure eight. Okay, so we have a figure eight going this way and going the opposite direction. Okay, then we can combine the wrist motion with your arm motion. So you have an arm motion, yeah? So basically, when I'm cutting this way, it's my wrist for blocking, but then it's my arm by the turn for cutting. So I can chop one, yeah, then I can just go one, two, one. So become wrist, arm, cut. Same thing this side, this wrist, then this arm. Okay, wrist, arm, motion, arm. Can of course do big movements as well. I prefer blocking smaller movement, cutting bigger movement. If I do bigger movements to block, I may lose the contact with the weapon when I'm blocking. So I want to usually block and use the block as almost like a tap, which press against the weapon, press against the opponent. Don't run back. I'm not blocking running back. I'm going to block going forward. So same thing when you say that my block, want to go forward. I want to get him in the corner with my blocks. I don't want to block going back. So I prefer, if I'm blocking, move forward. At least I'm concerned the distance of the weapon to you, so I need to back up so I can use the tip of the weapon because the opponent is too close. Otherwise, I block, I want to squeeze him. So again, here, forward, yes, here, forward. So for that reason, I'm not blocking going back. Because I'm not blocking going all the way here. Because that's the kind of running away, it's a kind of chicken block. I don't like chicken blocks. Okay? One. And one. Now we can combine this to one of the most fancy movements what you actually see in the saber. That's the figure-eight rotation. Okay. And this is a couple ways to do this. Oh, probably there's more ways to do this, but there's a couple ways I'm going to show you today. So first one, okay. We do cut from this up, turn your arm, wrist, and go up. I'm sorry, I'm going very good. I'm like, saber's not pointed flat, so I'm going to use it. From here, and the first variation is a block. First variation, I'm using block and cut this way. So, like you see, I'm using this motion, and I'm using this motion. So, I'm using two, or rather, like in the same combination. One, here. And the key is you rotate saber here, Stand from here, you turn your body, you don't have to rotate here. Okay, when you rotate here, you turn all the way from back. So I can see the one. Another variation is a club, it's a cut. So versus blocking, you can use cut and cut. Okay, and you have a cut. Cut. Okay, so you have cut, 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 cut. Okay, so that's two different variations. And whatever you feel you can do one or another. Okay, and that's basically